Here we have depicted a farm scene under the theme agri-tech. Sometimes there can be a mistake in detecting the moisture level in the soil, and it can end up in over irrigation or under irrigation of the field. To overcome this problem, we have used here a soil moisture sensor. This will accurately detect the moisture level in the soil, and it is attached to a sprinkler automatically, which would irrigate the fields as per the requirement.
So here I am going to show you all guys that how does this work. So here I have switched on the soil moisture sensors and it will now work. So if you remove the soil moisture sensor and it senses that the water is not there, and when it senses that water, the appropriate quantity of water is there in the soil, it will automatically stop.
Now here we have this smoke sensor. In case of a fire, to protect the crops from the fire, we have installed a smoke sensor. It would detect smoke and it is also attached to this sprinkler, which would automatically turn on in case of a fire. And it would put out, and it would then put out the fire.
Now let me show you the working of it. Now I have brought and lighted incense stick, and you can see the buzzer has started, and this indicates that the fire is there, and automatically the sprinklers also start to put off the fire.
These were some of the problems that the farmers face in the fields. Apart from this, we also target at organic farming, and for that we have cultured spirulina. Spirulina is a biomass of cyanobacteria which can be consumed by both animals and humans alike. Spirulina is a very good source of proteins and carbohydrates, and is used as a food supplement.
So this can also be used to increase the fertility of the soil. The main thing is that the spirulina, we would put spirulina into the field, and this will increase the fertility of the soil. Now, apart from all these things, we have made one more thing. Like, at the time of harvest, the amount of the rain water is not required for the irrigation, and no further irrigation of the crop is required. So if at the time of rain,
if
the
in
farmer,
such a situation it starts to rain, for that we have planted this dome, and it's a kind of a shed which operates on motors, and it can
like
be,
we have attached two motors here. Now let me show you the functioning of it. When rain arrives and farmer sees that his crop might get damaged, then he may use the manual control and will cover the field.
By the simple push of a button, the fields can be covered, and so the water that will fall on this, it would be directed through these pipes, and through these pipes they would be channelized to an underground tank which would harvest this rainwater. This rainwater can be further utilized by the sprinklers in case of a fire or for irrigation.
So guys, now let me brief you about the parts we have used. Now here we have used an MQ2 smoke sensor that can emit high amount of CO2, SO2 gases and can indicate the pollution. Here I have used a soil moisture sensor. It is a Japanese soil moisture sensor, and it can sense the water by the resistance. Now here we have used the Avishkar E-Series X brain, and this brain we have used to control the basic structure of our dome. And this brain is controlling the two motors here. The two motors are attached to the gear system here by controlling the dome. Now briefing you about our smoke sensors and our soil moisture sensor. These are functioning on the Arduino board. Arduino board is getting a power supply from the batteries. And this whole and one more thing guys, the whole dome is controlled by these two manual switches, which the farmer can use at the time of rain to protect its field from the rainwater.
Of all recurring problems that the farmers face in the fields, we have targeted some of them and have provided solutions to them. We have inculcated STEM in the field of agriculture so that these problems can be overcome.
So hereby, I would like to conclude my complete project. This project can be used in any part of the country and as it is cost efficient too. A farmer does not require much things and all the material used is of plastic. So, and at the last I would like to say you all that please support our project and our idea. Thank you.